All right, welcome back to Rave the Vote, everyone. My name is Mycah, and I'm here with Nithya Raman. She's a progressive candidate for Los Angeles City Council this year. Nithya, please introduce yourself and why you're running for LA City Council.
Hi, Mycah. Thank you so much for having me. My name is Nithya. I'm a candidate, as you said, for LA City Council in District 4. I'm an urban planner by training, and I'm running for office because I feel a real urgency for change at this moment. LA is facing some real crises around housing, around homelessness, around police reform, around climate change. And I feel like our elected officials don't feel the same sense of urgency that LA residents do to address those problems head on. And I'm running to do that.
That's amazing. And I actually agree wholeheartedly with you. So for those that might not know, could you actually briefly explain what City Council is and what it does?
Yeah, LA City Council is really powerful. So unlike cities like New York or Chicago that have more than 50 City Council members, here in Los Angeles, we only have 15 for a population of 4 million, which means every City Council district has 250,000 residents or more. Each council member acts like a mini mayor. That's been how things have run in Los Angeles for a really long time. They're really powerful people. They control land use. They control what's built and what's not built. They control homelessness policy. They control road space. They control the LAPD, LAX, the port, the DWP, which is our Department of Water and Power. So many things that shape our daily lives in Los Angeles are controlled by the LA City Council. And here in LA, we actually have a weak mayor, strong council system. So each council member is actually even more powerful than in other cities. So that's why it's an incredibly important position, but one where most people don't even know who their council member is. So how can you hold them accountable for doing better unless you know their name and what they're doing?
That's a very good point. It's a very good point. I actually wanted to touch on one of the issues that you mentioned there. You touched on homelessness, which is not just a major issue for Los Angeles, but also a big part of your platform. So I wanted to know if you could touch just on how the problem became this bad and what we can expect to see happen related to this issue if evictions start happening en masse across the country.
Yeah, that's a really great question. So homelessness is a complicated problem, but it's gone up a huge amount in the last few years. And the one most important reason for that increase in homelessness is the fact that housing prices have gone through the roof here in Los Angeles. And we neither have the kind of affordable housing production that we need to see to actually address demand, nor do we have a real system in place to protect people to stay in their housing when they're facing eviction or when they're facing some kind of vulnerability or housing insecurity. We just don't have that in Los Angeles. And part of the reason I'm running is really to bring that system into place.
And so part of that system is rent forgiveness, correct?
Yeah, so right now we're in this pandemic. It has been devastating for people's incomes. We've seen something like a third of people are not working right now here in Los Angeles, which is absolutely staggering amounts of unemployment. That means that a lot of people, it's really big. That means that a lot of people aren't paying their rent or they're paying part of their rent. And what's gonna happen as the expanded unemployment insurance from the federal government has already disappeared, doesn't look like it's coming back, is that more and more people are gonna be finding it impossible to be able to pay their rent. So here in Los Angeles, we really need to make sure that we have a strong eviction moratorium in place and that we put into place a strong rent forgiveness program. We have federal government sources available for this kind of funding. We can design it through the city. We can make sure that people are able to stay in their homes. We've talked about it on our website. We've written up a policy about it. The thing I want to emphasize is that we can't afford to make the same mistakes we made during the last financial crisis, when we didn't step in with everything that we could to help people not suffer. And that was bad for our economy. You know, when people leave a period of recession with huge amounts of personal debt, the entire economy suffers. So it's in our best interest, all of our best interests, to make sure that people are leaving this period as financially secure as possible. I feel like so many of us are going to be going to the polls in November to vote against Trump. And it's our responsibility to just do a little bit of research and look further down the ballot and make sure that everyone else we're voting for on that ballot aligns with our values. Don't just vote for whoever's already in office. Look around you.
Yes.
Have they built the city that you want to live in? Have they built the America you want to live in? If not, vote them out and bring in new voices.
Awesome. Nithya, you have a great voice yourself. So I appreciate you taking the time to spend with us and talk to us about local politics. Again, it is so, so important at a time like this. So we appreciate you and everything you're doing out there for the city.
And thank you so much. I'm really grateful that you guys shared this platform with me and excited to get all these new voters into our local races.
All right. Now, with that said, let's go back to the stream.